The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Gellin. Now, yesterday, I showed you some cool Sparkline tricks. I want to show you one more that I think is pretty cool. We had Sparklines yesterday. I'm going to change Spark columns yesterday. I'm going to change these to lines and add markers so we can see the individual markers. Now, one thing that Professor Tufte wrote about in his book, Beautiful Evidence, is he would actually add a bit of shading to the line that would show the acceptable values. So let's say here, if the acceptable tolerance was from 95 to 105, I want to add some gray shading. Now, Microsoft doesn't let you do this with Sparklines necessarily, but we can do it just using some clever Excel here. So I'm going to take the original data and I'm going to save it. I'm just going to copy it and paste it. And then up here, I'm going to change this data to all be 95, and then this data all be 105. That's going to be the guidelines for my tolerance. I want to draw shading between those two. And the best way that I found to do this is just to actually change the data right in the Sparkline so that way I can see it. Now I'm going to go back here to Insert, Shapes, and I'm going to add a rectangle. All right, you know what? Before I do that, I'm going to increase the zoom here a little bit so I can actually make this out a little bit better. Okay, so Insert, Shapes, we're going to choose a rectangle, and I'm going to just draw this in initially, going all the way across, try and get the bottom at the right spot, and then adjust it so that way the top is just lining up with that line. Now, a few tweaks we want to do here. I want to get rid of the outline, so shape outline, no outline, shape fill, I'm going to choose yellow color. All right, and now that I got rid of that outline, I kind of want to tweak it one more time just to make sure that it's going right through the dots at the top, and right through those dots, oh, too far, right through those dots at the bottom. Okay, now I can hear you say, well, hey, you obscured all the lines, we can't see anything. All right, so we have to come in here to format that. I'm going to use the dialog launcher here, and check this out, transparency, go up to about 75% or so, and now we can see right through that shading. Click close, all right, so now we've got the shading at the right spot. Final step is to take the real data that we replaced with that fake data and put it up here. And so now we can see that for line one, they were within tolerance the whole day. Line two started out within tolerance, but then it just went really bad. Line three was slightly out of tolerance, but then stayed in. And line four, wow, they had one point that was out of tolerance, but clearly something's going wrong there on that. Adding the shading, I think, is a great improvement. Again, not my idea. I got this from the Beautiful Evidence book, although I guess what is my idea is using the insert rectangle and the low transparency to actually bring that home to Excel and allow us to do that in Excel 2010. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.